The convertible house near Daylesford scores big points, not only for its environmentally sustainable principles, but for its highly effective fire and storm resistant structure. Today I meet with builder and designer Kevin Starling of Designology to discuss the innovative concept.
The energy generating principles we've used here is the house is actually completely off the grid.
So how do you generate and store the energy?
It's generated through the photovoltaics, the panels on the roof.
Mm-hmm.
That's taken back through the inverter, which is in the plant room, and it's converted back into 240 volts. It's stored in the battery bank in the plant room.
The roof and wall cladding is corrugated steel. What are the benefits of this?
It's a very cost-effective product. It's durable, mm-hmm. has low embodied energy, and it forms to the shape of the building very well. One of the big features of the building is the operable awnings, which are controlled by electric lineal actuators.
Mm-hmm.
These can be programmed to shut and open in various ways and combinations. They can be programmed to be controlled remotely,
mm-hmm.
or a combination of remotely and like a wall-mounted rocker switch. So these can be shut down in the event of an impending sort of bad weather event. One of the primary features of the house is exactly where we're standing now. It's the solar conservatory, which also doubles up as a solar collector. It's in the entry of the house and also the stairwell area.
Mm-hmm.
The air is drawn in through the solar collector at low level, so fresh air is drawn up through a series of expanded mesh shutters where it superheats it, takes it up to the ceiling where it's extracted through a heat recovery ventilation system. The air is then filtered and redistributed around the house, both on the first and lower floor. That is thermostatically controlled, so you can set it to the desired temperature. The convertible house design is really quite flexible and can be finished to any level of specification. This particular house is around 260 square metres, a double storey. Now that would cost in the vicinity of $400,000 to $450,000.
What about a single storey house?
Single storey, so a two bedroom version, would cost around about $200,000
to $250,000.
So again, I think it compares very favourably to the other alternatives out there. Just shows that you can be living remotely, totally off the grid. We have all the creature comforts that you would expect anywhere else in a city location, and it's just such a beautiful environment to live in. Look at the views, they're fantastic.
The convertible house prototype packages traditional green building features and innovative ideas into a highly effective fire and storm resistant structure. This is ideal for environmentally aware owners in both coastal and bushfire prone areas. But more than that, it's durable and it's a cost competitive solution to a range of housing challenges. This is Colette-Werden reporting for ArchiTel Australia.